Okay, now what we're going to do is go in with the little small end mill, our little eighth of an inch end mill, and machine out the remaining area there, the little nook or niche that the large end mill, the half inch end mill, couldn't fit into. All right, so I'm going to come in here and just get on top of the tool that I want to make the operation for. I don't have to do that, but that's one way to do it. If I do that and say right click, insert an operation, then automatically he's going to use that tool. He's using the workpiece, the geometry that we already defined, and I'm just going to give this a name here. I'm going to call it rest because we're kind of rest milling. We're milling out what remains in there from our first operation. All right, so let's go and try this. Like I said, what I like to do right away is go for broke and just see what happens when I generate. And it looks like, that looks perfect, except it's not. This is a whole lot of cutting that's already been done with the larger tool. So it doesn't make any sense to come back in here and cut all of this air out a second time. Also, some other stuff that needs to be fixed. Let me just replay that. You'll see that we're cutting down to this level. I'm going to do the same thing I did last time, and that is drop down to this lower cut level. I'll say cut level and then apply this range definition from the object. That is that that plane that we put in there earlier. And generate that. And you see now I have a one pass down at the bottom. Come back here. Down at the bottom of this thing. All right. So, like I said, I don't want to machine all this other material. That just doesn't make any sense. So what we'd like to do is confine the cutting action to the stuff left over from when we cut it the first time. Okay, I'm gonna need to change some stuff, so I'm gonna go ahead and okay this and keep that operation because it's almost right. But I want to do some other stuff here. Okay, and one thing is I want to make both the cavity mill and the rest milling happen inside of the same program. Oops, what did I do? Drop that in there. So now both of these inherit from the from a program named program. I could have inserted a new program. I'm just going to use this one. It sits in there kind of generically. And now I'm going to come back and edit this operation some more. A lot of times students will get something almost right and then they'll hit cancel because something's not working right for them or they realize they need to change something. It's real easy to come in here and make changes after you've made, partially defined an operation. So I recommend that you go ahead and just say okay and save the operation, then come back and edit it as you need to. All right, let's see, where is this? Under cutting parameters. So right here, this image for cutting parameters, I want to come in, and what I want to do is I want to contain cutting. I want to contain it to what has already been cut, and that is the in-process work. So in-process work is the work that's been partially machined, and I'm going to use level based, say OK, and we'll just try generating one more time, and you see that's a lot more realistic. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and save that, say OK, and now let's have a look at how this gets cut. I want to right-click and do a toolpath verify. That's something you should know about. Toolpath verify, and we'll have a look at what this looks like. Slow things down just a little bit. All right, so there's the first operation and then the second operation. So you see it goes in there and cleans up rather nicely. All right, so that is... that's confining the operation to the end process work, and that's this is the next step that I want you to do. All right, so I stopped that video, but I had to come back in here because I really didn't like machining that deeply with that little 1/8 inch end mill. We are intentionally, I'll zoom out here, we are intentionally going in and machining into this spacer down here. That is something that I do want to do. I'm doing that on purpose. But I don't think we need to go as deep as this 0625 below the surface. So I'm just going to show you that you can go in We've got everything done. It's all good. And we can come in here and we can just tweak things. We can edit. In this case, we're going to edit our range definition bottom. And I can just pull this up until it's just below the surface. And I'll be happy with it right there. So really just 0.135 will be fine. So I'm going to update it like that. That eliminates a whole pass, I believe. Yeah, there we go. So now we do it in two passes instead of three. And that's going to, you know, that's cut our cycle time down by a third. And I just like that a lot better. But remember, don't forget that you can edit these after you've made them. After you've made the operations, it is very easy to go in and edit those.